YouTube haters. We're going to talk about why they're kind of a necessary evil and why they're a good thing. Welcome back, everybody. I'm Karen Carr, and I teach real estate agents how to get more business for free from YouTube. If this is your first time here, you really should hit that subscribe button because I put out new videos every Thursday and they're all about great topics just like this. When people start making YouTube videos for the first time, they often are very nervous about the YouTube haters. I'm not gonna lie, they are out there. There are a lot of people that love to sit in their dark in the basement and troll the internet and say mean comments. But when you start getting those types of comments, it's actually a good thing because that tells you that people are watching your content. If nobody even knew you existed, nobody would comment on your videos at all. The more boring and safe you play it, the less views you're going to get, the less engagement, the less comments in general. However, the more you take a stand with your opinion, the more controversial, the more polarizing, the more you're going to have people say some negative things about you. But when you go out on a limb, you put yourself out there, you make videos, you're gonna say some things that may be unpopular. For instance, I live in Savannah, Georgia, and if I make videos talking about Savannah, I will invariably get people that will make snarky comments. They might talk about how hot and muggy it is, or they'll talk about the crime statistics. They'll say something about the area because they personally don't like it. Big deal. If you are talking about a topic that might be somewhat controversial or polarizing, you should definitely expect that you're going to get some YouTube haters on those videos in particular. But here's my opinion on this. The fact that you get any comments at all is a good thing because that means people are watching your content. If they say 90% positive things and 10% of them are negative, that's okay in my book. I watched a video this morning. She had 77,000 views and hundreds of likes, but 60 something people had given it a thumbs down. Now, anytime somebody engages with the video, that tells the algorithm that people are watching. So even a dislike, even a thumbs down, is still kind of a good engagement signal in the eyes of the YouTube algorithm. So if you're getting lots and lots of comments, and every now and then you get a negative one, that's okay. It is still telling YouTube that people are finding, watching, and engaging with your content, and all of those are good things. Now, why do people even say anything negative in the first place? Well, look at it this way. It's very easy to be anonymous on the internet. People will say things online that they would never have the guts to say to your face because it's totally anonymous. You don't know their name, you don't know where they live, you can't really fight back with them, except online. And so I think it gives them this false sense of security because you don't know who they are. Trust me, if we knew exactly who was making that comment, they'd be much less likely to be as offensive as they can tend to be. Now, should you care? I'll tell you, the first time I ever got a thumbs down on my video or a nasty comment, I was heartbroken. I was like, I'm putting myself out there, I'm allowing myself to be vulnerable, and then people are saying mean things to me. It really made me feel terrible. And boy, that night I cracked open a big old bottle of wine. But then I thought about it and thought, okay, so is this person my ideal customer avatar? And if you haven't watched that video that I've done before, you should watch the video about attracting your ideal client, because that's very important. But I digress. Is that person my ideal customer avatar? They really are not. Okay, so they were totally nameless and anonymous in this comment. Does their opinion of this video have any bearing on how I should conduct my business going forward? No, of course not. Because if they are not paying me, if they are not hiring me, then I don't really care what their opinion is, to be honest. They are not my ideal customer avatar. They are not my tribe. They are not my people. If they don't like me, they don't like my content, so be it. Everyone is entitled to their opinion. They can go off and live their happy little life, or probably their very unhappy little life. Does their opinion of me or my work or my business carry any weight with me at all? No, it doesn't. they're probably a very unhappy person. I mean, think about it. If you are successful and happy and confident, do you sit around on your computer writing snarky comments on the internet? No, you don't. When you are happy and confident and successful, you're too busy leading a happy life to be making all kinds of rude comments about somebody's video that they did about a real estate endeavor in whatever city. So I figure the person leaving that comment probably is not a very happy person down, deep down inside. And you know what? I feel kind of bad for them. If this is how you get your jollies, is leaving nasty comments, then you got a lot bigger problems than my video. One of the greatest sayings I've ever heard, and I wish I knew who said it so I could give them credit, but it is, what other people think of you is none of your business. And it's totally true. You can't control what they think about you. So you can only do what you're going to do, what you think is best for your business, what's going to propel you forward, what's going to take you from selling 10 houses a year to 50 houses a year. And whether or not that person likes it is really none of your business. You need to do what you think is best for you and keep moving forward. Now, I will say, when you get a comment about the quality of your video, perhaps they say the lighting was terrible, the audio was bad, you say too much, something like that, it's very easy to take offense and get angry. But you know what? Just step back, try to not think about it for a day. And then the following day, when you've calmed down a little bit, stop and think about it. Was there any truth in what they said? If there is, if you're really being honest with yourself and there is some truth in what they said, then that's an opportunity for you to improve for the next time. If somebody said the audio was really bad in my video, then I know that I need to fix that because nobody will watch my video if they can't hear what I'm saying. If they say it looks like I'm in a dungeon because it's so dark, then that's an opportunity for you to improve your lighting. That is not a personal attack of your character. It is not a personal attack of your appearance or anything like that. That's an opportunity for you to improve your craft and be better. I had somebody say that they hated my backdrop one time, and I thought, okay, well, this is my office. This is what my home office looks like, and I don't really plan to redecorate my home office because one person said they didn't like it. So if you don't like it, don't watch. Problem solved. But when they go on the attack and they criticize your appearance, they say anything about your age or your size or your weight or something, YouTube has this glorious feature called block and delete. YouTube will let you not only delete the comment, but you can then block that person from ever commenting on your channel again. I've only had to do that a few times, but boy, there is no better feeling in the world than deleting that comment and blocking that jackass from ever commenting on my channel again. Because those are not people we need in our sphere. Those are not people we need anywhere in our world. I will listen to constructive criticism all day long, but if you're gonna comment on how flat my stomach is not, or the little laugh lines I have right here, here's what I have to say about that. So in a nutshell, when you get YouTube haters, that is a sign that you are on the right path. You are getting seen, you are getting recognition, you are getting visibility and views and engagement on your videos, so don't stop. You will never appeal to everybody. Not everybody in the world is going to like you. Recognize that. Be okay with that. You are only trying to attract your ideal client, your ideal tribe. YouTube haters actually are a sign that you're doing it. So please don't give up. Keep going. Have you checked out the Industry Syndicate yet? I am a proud member. I would love it if you would click this link down below, check out their website, everybody that's doing podcasts and flash briefings and all the things, because they've got some really awesome content and I know you don't want to miss it. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.